Hello, hello, mic test. It's quite a lot of information, to be honest, that they are providing in MS Excel directly. And as you can see, I have not written even a single line of code in this video. And you can see we have extracted a lot of data from making a screener to getting the options data to getting the ETF data, fundamental data, etc., etc. So there's a lot of things that we have extracted in Excel. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the third video of our playlist on exploring the EODHD financial data API. In the first video, we talked about the basic things on like exploring this entire platform. We went through the documentation and we explored the free data financial data API of EODHD. In the second video, we made a detailed stock screener using both free and paid data APIs. And in this video, we are going to learn how to use their Excel API add-ins in order to extract all the information directly in either in MS Excel or Google spreadsheet without using any code. This is how we'll be completing this entire playlist on EODHD. If you guys are new to my YouTube channel, guys, on this channel I convert all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, exploring some highly valuable finance APIs like this one, making some Pine script trading strategies, etc., etc. So if this is something that you are interested in, then you should click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are a lot of playlists that are coming that are already in my pipeline. And you guys already know that I upload videos every Saturday, and yes, this will keep on happening. So if you don't want to miss out on those amazing free content, then just stay tuned by subscribing to my YouTube channel. Perfect. So in this video, we'll just directly go to the Excel add-in functionality, right? So they have given all the information here directly. So let's follow all the steps one by one. To be honest, I have not done it in the past and I'm also exploring it for the first time. So this is great. I just wanted to provide a candid experience on this video. That's why I kept it in this way only. So let's do it. Perfect. So the first thing that we need to do here is we'll have to download the Excel add-in here. Okay, perfect. It's getting downloaded. Okay, got it. So we'll have to install this thing. Welcome to the installation wizard. EOD add-in. Click on next. Accept the agreement. Next, 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 and install. Finish. Okay. The add-in includes downloading the data via EOD API with chart auto generation. Change the test API key to your API key. Add tickers you want to download the data for. Okay, got it. And get results directly to your Excel file with charts. Downloader for end of the day stock API. Got it. So there are good Excel templates as well. That's very good. I like it. Okay, we can actually provide it in VBA code as well. So we can actually do some automation on Excel as well. Perfect. So let's open the Excel file. Okay, so while opening it, automatically started this like open this thing with EODHD API's financial add-in. You'll be able to download all these things. Register, login, insert API key. Let's just click to insert API. Okay, got it. I'll paste my API key here. Okay, so it has saved the API key. Do I need to log in as well? Let's click on login. Perfect. I have logged in as well. Now let's hide it. Ah, that's great. I've got this ribbon already. I didn't need to do anything here. So yes, we have actually provided the API key over there, and I think that's now connected. Let's explore things on how to extract the historical data. I click here, tickers. Okay, so let me just write AAPL.US. I want daily data from. Okay, I will go from, I don't know, want that old data. So from 2010 January to 2023 today. Yeah, descending order, one worksheet only, smart table. I don't know what it is, but let's see. Let's click here. Perfect. So that's great. So I've got the entire table of this historical data of Apple. I can actually provide some filters here. For example, say newest to oldest. it will change it like this. I have open, high, low, close, adjusted open, adjusted high, adjusted low, and adjusted close, and volume data here. That's great. Let's see what else is there. So I'll just name this one as well as historical data. Perfect. Second one, intraday data. Let's see what is intraday data. Get intraday historical data. Okay, ticker msft.us. Interval, I want 1 minute interval data. Okay, that's fine. Let's do it from one ascending. Let's unselect this, uncheck this, and load. Perfect. It took some time, but yeah, the data is also a lot. So there are 65,000 rows here. If you see, let me just expand it a bit. So what type of data do we have? Data of time and timestamp. I think they're the same thing with different formats. Then we have open, high, low, close, and volume. That's great. I am not sure what is GMT offset, which is always zero, I think. So there's no problem with that. So this is intraday data. That's cool. I'm actually a bit curious if you want to extract it continuously, then in that case we'll have to write a VBA code to run this query again and again to get the intraday data continuously. But that's not a problem. It won't be a very, I would say, long code. If you guys want me to make a video on that, mention that in the comment section. If I get a lot of comments related to the same thing, then I will make a video on that as well. So this is intraday data. Fundamental data, so that's the third tab. I'll click here. Okay, so these types of data are available. All data, general, highlights. If you remember, guys, I also created a drop down like this one only in the stock screener that I created in the last video. If you have not watched that video, then I highly recommend, because I've already automated this thing in Python on a very interactive web application called Streamlit. So, and all this information is over there already. So yeah, no worries. So these are the fundamental data. Bulk fundamentals, let's just select in balance sheet as of now. Ticker is MSFT, or let's do TSLA.US this time. Perfect. So this is the balance sheet of Tesla for how many years? From 2007. Perfect. And this is quarterly, and then here is annually. So they have actually provided both of them with grouping of like this. So basically there's a grouping of quarterly, and then we have it for annually as well. Perfect. The filing date is available here, currency, and then other things. Okay, these are all the items of balance sheet. That's great. I am actually curious, very curious, to see what is there inside the bulk fundamentals. Just before that, guys, I have a very important information to share. Recently I launched a course on Python for financial programming. So if you are trying to learn Python for finance from scratch, then this is something that you might be interested in. Just go to my website, which is fpretwick.com/python. Over here you will see two buttons, Indian candidates, non-Indian candidates. So you can click as per your location. It will redirect you to this, the main website, where the entire course information is available. You'll see that there are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes, and 3 assignments with 2 live projects. And this is the entire syllabus of this course for all the people who are interested to learn Python from scratch and who are struggling learning Python on their own. I highly recommend it, because it's very, very affordable, and I have covered a lot of things from a very, very simplistic eyesight. And in the end, in session 4 and 5, you'll see stock analysis and investment portfolio creation projects, which are my personal projects. We did it using some financial analysis. If you use RTK40 code, you'll get an instant 40% discount, which is only available for the first 100 candidates. So yes, guys, I'll see you in the course. Let's come back to our code. Okay, so here I'll provide ticker TSLA.US. Okay, there's another option here. Let me just write APL.US, and then third one, MSFT.US, and one spreadsheet, and one worksheet separated. I'm just interested in this one itself. And load. You're going to download 3 symbols. Do you want to proceed? Yes. Perfect. So we have got multiple sheets here and a lot of data. So for Tesla, Apple, and Microsoft, all these different things are available now. Earnings, I think, yeah. So it has actually given all the data for the 3 companies here. And I think it's annual data. Perfect. Let's see what else. Get ETF. Okay. I'll create a new sheet here called ETF. Let's click here. Ticker. Okay. ETF ticker. I don't know any ETF ticker. Let's go to their documentation. So over here you can see the code VTI is a code is an ETF, which is Vanguard Total Stock Market Index Fund ETF shares. So let's try this one only, VTI. Let's write VTI. It's not B, it's VTI. And let's click on load. Insert exchange as well. So let's try US only, dot US and load. Perfect. That's great. We have got VTI US. Okay, that's grouped already. So yeah, all this information. That's great. So a lot of information about an ETF, because mostly the data is not very easily available for ETF except the pricing data. So that's good. That's good. That's a lot of information. Volatility, Sharpe ratio, 3-year return, individual stock level analysis. Perfect. Let's go to the next one, which is get options. Let's click here, ticker AAPL.US, from this to this, load. Okay, perfect. So I think this is the options data of Apple as well, right? Implied volatility, put volume, call volume, what else, open interest, call open interest, and options count. What next? Get bulk EOD data. I think it will just give me all this data in just one go, so I'm not interested in that. So let's see what is the stock screener here. I would like to create this one. Sector is technology, industry is information technology services. I'll change this to US and say I'll just write Microsoft, but let's just keep this one. I want all tech companies based out of US exchange, which is basically Nasdaq in this case. So let's see, what do we get? Perfect. So we've got all the companies who belong to US, and the sector is technology, industries, information technology services. Yeah, so we have this list of 100 companies here. We can change, I would say we can increase the limit from 100 to a bigger number as well. So here, over there, you can see the limit here as 100, so you can increase it to 500 as well. So yeah, perfect. So then the next one is list of exchanges, list of cryptocurrencies, etc. If you want to get the list of those things, that's good. And then the settings if you want to change your API and all. So yeah, it's quite a lot of information, to be honest, that they are providing in MS Excel directly. And as you can see, I have not written even a single line of code in this video. So yes, all this information requires no coding, and you can see we have extracted a lot of data, from making a screener to getting the options data, to getting the ETF data, fundamental data, etc., etc. So there's a lot of things that we have extracted in Excel. So yes guys, if you like this video, please click on the like button and also click on the subscribe button, because I know these are just two clicks for you, but these mean a lot to me. Most of my YouTube viewers are not subscribing to my YouTube channel, and I got an email from YouTube. So I'm just having a humble request, please support my channel by clicking on like and subscribe button, because it will give me motivation to continue uploading this quality educational content for free. For any freelancing inquiries, you can reach out to me on this email address, and I'll reply as soon as possible. And last but not the least, the link of my course is in the description box. Please check it out and let me know if you have any feedbacks. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. This was the last video of this playlist. I hope you liked it. Click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you'll see this entire playlist on EODHD. Over there you'll see one of my most loved video on making a trading bot on MT5 in less than 1 hour. The next playlist would be a very interesting playlist as well. So just stay tuned. The next video will be live on next Saturday. And until then, peace.